Greetings, everyone, and welcome back once again to Horizon Zero Dawn. I guess I should probably stop messing around in photo mode, so... Alright, let's see. Oh, you know, before we even deal with that, there is something very important we need to do up here, and that is... There is a power cell up here. In order to get it, we have to climb... Right up here.
This will do nicely.
And then up here. Try not to look down, though. Because, yeah, that's a long drop. Yeah, what have we here?
I keep finding these power cells. What do they do?
Presumably they provide power. Oh, what a nice view. You can actually see a lot farther away from here than the area where you're allowed to travel in the game. There is a whole section of the map way beyond there, but there's really nothing in it. And you can't go there because invisi-walls. In any case...
Got too much already.
Actually, didn't I pick up a fast travel pack at some point? I did pick up a fast travel pack. Well, okay, whatever. Executive data storage. 6% power remaining after hundreds of years. Not bad.
All data has been erased from this device. Do you wish to deploy Alpha privileges to recover purged data?
Oh yes, I believe I do.
A file has been recovered.
So, Ted went out of his way to destroy all the evidence. See what we've got.
Elizabeth, good to, it's been years.
Where's your legal team, Ted?
No need. I dropped all 18 lawsuits the moment you landed.
What a nice guy.
I assume your data confirms this.
Alright, this promises to be interesting.
Perhaps we could have lunch brought in. You know, get reacquainted.
I know you, Ted. You've screwed something up, something big, or you wouldn't have eaten the crow necessary to get me here. So, spit it out.
There's... a glitch in the chariot line.
Your killer robots?
Peacekeepers, yes. Those.
So shut them down.
Obviously, Liz, we would, if we could. They're not responding.
Are you telling me a swarm has gone rogue, Ted?
It's worse than that.
Show me the data, then. And I'll take that lunch. Alone.
Ted Faro brought Elizabeth Sobek here. But they hated each other.
Another file has been recovered.
So, since we're not likely to directly come across the information on why they hate each other, basically the reason they hated each other was because when Elizabeth left Faro Automated Solutions, because, you know, she was rightfully upset with them for abandoning green robot technology in favor of military technology, Ted decided that he did not want Elizabeth Sobek leaving and starting her own company, so he decided to sue her to prevent her from being able to basically become his competitor.
This isn't a glitch. It's a catastrophe.
Fully aware. It's bad.
Bad?
Jesus, Liz.
It's not bad, Ted. It's apocalyptic. You built a line of killer robots.
Peacekeepers.
That consume biomass as fuel.
In emergencies.
And you made them capable of self-replication.
Limited self-manufacture, controlled.
Not anymore. The glitch severed chain of command. The only nation this swarm answers to now is itself.
You think I did?
Everything else is just food. And at the rate it's replicating, Ted, it will strip the Earth bare in 15 months. We're not talking fall of civilization. We're talking extinction.
I get it, Liz. So how do I stop it while it's contained?
It's not contained. It can't be.
You know what I mean.
Right. Before the truth gets out, you mean.
Liz, I will do anything you say. Keep working it, and whatever you recommend, I'll do.
I'm gonna hold you to that, Ted.
The Faro robots threatened all life on Earth. But somehow she defeated them. The world of the old ones fell, but life went on, or we wouldn't be here.
A final file has been recovered.
This promises to be educational.
Project Zero Dawn. Jesus, Liz. There has to be another way.
If there were a nicer way to fix your mess, I would have proposed it.
But this? This? When I asked you to find a cure, I didn't expect it to be worse than the disease.
It's not, Ted. It may be grim, but it's our only chance. Now sign the proposal.
Sign it? I can't sign that.
Yes, you can.
That? Liz, I cannot in good conscience sign that.
You've got a choice, Ted.
I know.
I'm speaking to you from a VTOL en route to U.S. Robot Command. In 15 minutes, I meet with General Harris and the rest of the Joint Chiefs.
What? Are you crazy?
Now your choice is what I tell them. Sign, and I'll tell them the wealthiest corporation on Earth has guaranteed the funds necessary to build Zero Dawn. Exactly as I've designed it. Or don't sign, and I will make sure they and everyone else on this planet knows the real cause of the glitch.
Jesus, Liz. You don't have to threaten me. I'll sign.
Look on the bright side, Ted. From here on out, you get to do what you've always been good at. Footing the bill while others get their hands dirty.
God forgive me.
What made her solution so terrible? What did she do to stop the robots?
Executive access detected. Express lift opened.
Well, that's our way out of here.
Add up. Sobek couldn't have been my mother. She lived ages ago. All this searching, and I'm still no closer.
That's your reaction to everything you've just learned? To whine like a spoiled child?
You should really try talking that way to me face to face.
As you wish. Do you really have no idea how monumental are the discoveries you just made, Aloy? I expected more of you.
So, you have a face. Got a name to go with it?
Of all the questions you could ask right now, that's the one you choose. I've spent decades searching the ruins of the old ones, trying to solve the mystery of what happened to them. For years, I've suspected that Faro robots destroyed this civilization, but I could never confirm it. And in minutes, you uncover more ancient knowledge than I have in a lifetime, and what you want to know is my name. Silence, that's my name. Now, why don't you try asking another question? something less trivial.
Well, he's not wrong. We really can't argue with him here.
All right, Silence. You've made your point. I came to these ruins hoping to learn more about this Elizabeth Sobeck. And I have, but I still don't understand my connection to her. Or why the Eclipse is trying to kill me. Or who Hades is. No answers, just one question after another.
Exactly. Which is why it's time to expand your frame of inquiry. Only then will you see just how big your problems really are.
What exactly are you talking about?
You've chased a personal riddle into a crowd of larger mysteries. The common thread is your connection to Elizabeth Sobeck.
But what is that connection? She couldn't have been my mother if she lived centuries ago.
We don't know the connection yet. The only way to find out is to keep going, to keep making discoveries. Thanks to you, we've only just now learned that Pharaoh robots once threatened to end life on Earth.
But it didn't happen. The Old One's civilization was destroyed, but life was saved.
Obviously. So, what did Elizabeth do? How did she stop the robots before all was lost?
What was Project Zero Dawn?
Exactly the question. Now, are you ready to go get the answer?
Of course I am.
Then why are you still standing here?
Not so fast, Silence. You've got some explaining to do.
I've told you quite enough. If you still got questions, be quick about it and stop wasting my time.
You said you've known for some time that Pharaoh war machines destroyed the civilization of the Old Ones.
The evidence pointed that way. But until now, I never knew the full scope of their danger. That they could process organic matter into fuel, or that the Horus class could manufacture more robots. Like a cauldron on legs.
But the robots we've seen so far, the Corruptors and Deathbringers, they don't do those things.
Not yet, anyway. So far, we haven't encountered any that are undamaged. At full power, who knows what they're capable of. Now, if that's enough talking, be on your way.
Oh no. I'm just getting started. You've been getting a free ride on my focus, risking nothing while I risk everything. All I have to do is take this thing off my head, and you'll be blind, deaf, and dumb. So quit complaining and answer my questions.
Very well. Proceed.
Yeah, let's ring this guy for everything he's worth.
Who are you, Silence? And what are your intentions?
You really need to make this personal. I'm a lone wanderer who left his tribe behind a long time ago. An explorer of forbidden places, a searcher of lost knowledge. Exactly as I said.
Why do you know so much about the Eclipse?
I happen to know a lot about a lot of things. If what you're really asking is whether I work for the Eclipse or anyone else, I don't. I am nothing if not independent.
You've been using my focus to spy on me. How's that possible?
Every focus emits a signal, a voice that only other focuses can hear. I know how to string those voices together, how to make them talk to each other, to communicate, even over vast distances.
How do you learn to do that?
Years of study and experimentation. In principle, it's not so different from how you override machines. I override focuses.
And you can spy through other Eclipse's focuses, too.
Usually. All I'll say is that overriding the connections is complicated.
Is there any chance that Elizabeth Sobeck could still be alive somehow?
It's highly unlikely, but not impossible. Some of the ancient data I've recovered includes mentions of life extension techniques. Pharmaceuticals, mostly. An ancient word for medicine. But some were still trying to perfect ways of freezing and unfreezing people.
Freezing and unfreezing people?
Cryogenics, they called it. But there were problems with it. Given Elizabeth's technological acumen, I can't definitively rule out that she found a way to make herself immortal. But this is speculation. Wasting time.
Incorrectly referred to as cryogenics, the field Silence is talking about is actually called cryonics. Cryogenics is something entirely different.
So far as I can tell, the Eclipse are just following orders. It's Hades who wants me dead. Who is he?
I don't know. The Eclipse describe him as a buried shadow, some kind of devil.
That thing that spoke to me outside, that made that focus explode. That was Hades. It didn't seem like a person or a machine. More like a phantom, with a terrible voice.
All that's certain is that he wants you dead.
Because of my connection to Elizabeth. Has to be.
Hades is using the Eclipse to resurrect Pharaoh robots.
But if Elizabeth found a way to stop them centuries ago, if she made special weapons, maybe Hades is worried I'll do the same thing.
In some of the ancient data I've recovered, there are hints of so-called super weapons being developed. Maybe to stop the robots, the civilization of the old ones had to destroy itself.
Elizabeth told Ted Faro she was headed for a place called U.S. Robot Command to tell people about Zero Dawn.
The place still exists as a ruin. The Asaram call it the Grave Horde.
Grave Horde? Cheery name.
You'll find it in the Eastern Mountains, buried under the tangled coils of a metal devil, or a BOR-7 Horus, rather, as we're learning to call them. I'll contact you when you get there.
I can't wait. Someday we'll meet in person, and your manners had better be improved. Well, getting down will be a lot faster than getting up here, at least. U.S. Robot Command next, to learn the secrets of Zero Dawn.
Now, getting down could be as simple as just a fast travel, but we'll do this the way the developers intend.
Gray light lifting. Snow's gonna clear.
It amazes me that there are just random pieces of meat in treasure chests. Well, supply crates, technically. At the top of this ancient building where almost certainly nobody has been for the last however many hundreds of years have gone by. It's been really about 1,000 years. I believe that this game is set in the year 3047 or thereabouts. So it's been a hot minute.
Can't carry more.
You know, it would be really nice if I could even just make a little bit of room for some blaze. Well, I tried. Oh, nope, now I'm going the wrong way. All right, well, I think I've made my point. Grave Horde is way over here. And this is why I went out of my way to clear the bandit camp at Hollow Fort. So that now I have a staging area for my trip to the Grave Horde. Now, let's just save the game. Just in case. Oh, really? Dead Watcher is even in the camp. Okay, now... You know, I have to say, as crude as they are, these bandit camps do make great places to live for people who just want a place to live. They're well fortified. They're generally located in pretty defensible spots. Now the question is, can I actually cut through here to get where I need to go? It looks like maybe I can. Looks like I might get away with this.
So this is as high as we go? Okay.
There we go. I believe I have gotten away with it. Oh, that's fine. We don't need to worry about those. Although I think there is a Stormbird around here somewhere that we might have to worry about.
Low and quiet, does it?
I'm really glad that falling through the ice on a heavy machine isn't a thing. Also, I should like to avoid those glint hawks. If at all possible. No, it looks like that's not going to be possible. No, maybe it is. Got out of the line of sight of most of them. And the chargers I don't care about. Because they're not really a threat. So yeah, you can see the Horus up there, the main body sticking out directly above Aloy's head, and then the tentacles all wound through the mountain. You can also see some ancient analog vehicles here as well, some tanks. Pardon me.
Bleed for the shadow.
Pardon me, excuse me. Oh, great.
You can't evade the shadow.
You know what I wish?
Shadow, take you.
I wish I weren't stuck. Okay, I think it's time to...
Don't run out now! No. You cannot run from righteousness!
Yeah, get him! Oh, great. The Glint Hawks are coming.
Grave Horde, in the shadow of a metal devil. Great.
Now, while we are here, there is one thing that we should take care of. Really, probably before we proceed. You see these, you see these nice little lights leading up the cliff?
These look like Banuk markings. Is this the way to their territory?
Look at this nice little brightly lit path.
You don't look like you know this path, Hunter.
And I presume you do.
Seems you're a long way from anything. Where does this trail lead?
For me, it leads south. Away from the Banuk. Past the Grave Horde. Banukai, watch over me. This is the quickest way out of the cut, instead of going all the way through Oseram territory. And take it from me. You want a quick way out of the cut.
I haven't even arrived yet. Why would I want to leave?
Strange machine attacks? A curse on the mountain? It's enough to make me look forward to Meridian.
Interesting.
What kind of strange machines? And what kind of curse?
Machines tougher and crazier than anything in the south, I heard. And smoke comes off the mountain like a funeral pyre all day and night. But like I said, I just pass through now.
What sort of place is the cut?
It's on the edge of everywhere. The edge of Ban-Ur, the edge of the mountains, the edge of other tribes' territories. It's suffered in the war with the Karja. But it suffered before that, too. Life there is a test. To survive out on the edge.
Not exactly homey. I can see why you'd want to move on.
Home is what you carry in a roll on your back.
Well, that's an interesting perspective on life, but for many people even today, one that is still relevant.
You're going to Meridian?
Yes. I was named an envoy to the Karja King's court. No one else wanted to do it. It's not so bad. I just recount the songs from Ban-Ur, and the Karja draw their funny little glyphs. I tell them of the machine's growing anger, and the Karja King still offers aid, even though he knows the Banuk will not accept it.
Well, why have an envoy, then?
Well, thanks for the warning. I'm curious about these machines, though.
And the warning rolled off you. I understand. You adventurers are all alike. Good luck.
Actually, I'm not really an adventurer anymore. There was the whole business about that arrow to the knee.
I can't spare the weight.
Well, she says home is what you carry on your back, but this looks more like a sled of the type that you drag behind you. Well, that's all very educational. Just wanted to make sure I had accepted this quest before we head out, because... there we are. Because I'm going to want a quick way back here. And I want to make sure I have unlocked that campfire. For now, though, I'm going to call it. So, thank you all very much for joining me. And I look forward to seeing you next time. Take care, everybody.